Hello! In this episode of Bug Bounty Reports Explained, I will show you a way to steal documents and data of other users from Dropbox-owned HelloSign application by exploiting an SSRF in the integration with Google Drive. I am sure that this bug is still present in many integrations out there, so make sure to stick until the end of the video, where I will show you how you should test for this bug. Link to the original post by Harsh, also known as HTTP Void, is in the description. Enjoy! This episode is sponsored by Integrity. Integrity is Europe's biggest bug bounty platform with over 400 programs to hack on. I hugely appreciate Integrity for investing a lot in community enablement. They create an awesome Bug Bites newsletter, they create monthly XSS challenges, they even have a great YouTube channel. If you are not one of over 50,000 hunters, check out Integrity now using the link from the description. HelloSign is an application owned by Dropbox that's used to sign documents. It also integrates with Google Drive, so you can ask someone to sign a document that you store on your Google Drive. HelloSign must somehow access files from your drive. And there are a few ways to do this integration, but let's see how it worked in this example. Of course, first you must authenticate to your Google account and authorize HelloSign to access your files. Then this iframe pops up with the list of your files. When you finally choose a file that you would like to sign, the iframe sends a post message to HelloSign, which contains the file ID of the file that you've chosen. Then you send the request with this file ID to HelloSign, and HelloSign communicates with Google Drive API to fetch this file on the server and then serves you this file. So HelloSign here acts as a proxy. And of course, I'm simplifying this process a bit. It takes a few requests, but there is nothing interesting or worth mentioning in between the first and the last one. But let's take a closer look at what actually HelloSign server does to fetch this file. Before the attack was successful, the hunter had to assume these facts, which we now know for certain. This is Google Drive API endpoint to serve a file. It contains the file ID, which you had to send to HelloSign server first. But this endpoint does not respond directly with a file content. It returns a JSON with metadata about the file. This metadata contains the download URL, which is an actual address to the file contents. So HelloSign must make another request to this URL to fetch the file, which can eventually be served to you. So here HelloSign makes two requests, and whenever you have a functionality where the server makes HTTP requests to the URL which you at least partially control, you should be thinking about SSRFs, about the possibility to trick the server into sending these requests to other locations. And when we look at these two addresses, the second one doesn't seem to be under control at all, because we can't influence the URL where our files is stored by Google Drive. The first one is a bit better because at least we control the file ID, but unfortunately it's not possible to trick the server into sending this request to other hosts if you only control the part after the slash. What you can do, however, is you can try to control the path and parameters of the request. So let's take a look at the reference of this endpoint to see if there's anything that could give us, for example, an open redirect. On the first sight, it doesn't look like so. None of these parameters looks to be particularly interesting. However, when we scroll back to the top, we can see a mention of an alt equals media parameter. When it's provided, the server doesn't return a JSON with metadata about the file, but it returns the file itself. If HelloSign application would use this parameter, they wouldn't have to make two requests to first fetch the metadata and then fetch the file, but they could fetch the file with a single request. So let's think about what would happen if we would inject this parameter into the file ID and it would not be encoded properly. The server would return a whole file to the first request by HelloSign, but HelloSign would not know about it and it would try to parse JSON, thinking it's metadata. So all you could do with an image or a PDF is to force a JSON parsing error. Nothing interesting. But if you do this to an actual valid JSON, then HelloSign will try to parse this JSON, extract things like the title and other metadata from the file, and most importantly, it would also extract the download URL and send a request to this address to then fetch you the response. So this is a full read SSRF. You can trick the server into sending requests to arbitrary locations and the server gives you the response. What's the impact of this? The HelloSign application is hosted on AWS. You can use the metadata URL which contains AWS credentials which you can use to log in to the server. From there, you have multiple ways to steal data of other users of HelloSign application. That's why this vulnerability was classified as critical and rewarded over $17,500. Note the fact that Google Drive API was not vulnerable. It behaved exactly like its documentation says. It's a bug in the integration. There are probably thousands of applications that integrate with Google Drive. A part of them uses the same flow that HelloSign application use, and a part of this surely is still vulnerable to this attack. So whenever you see an application that works like this, that it takes the file ID from you, fetches the file on the server, you should try adding alt equals media parameter to the file ID to see what happens. If you see an error, particularly about JSON parsing, then it's a good chance that you just found this SSRF. What you should do then is you should prepare a JSON that looks like a metadata about the file. For that, refer to Google Drive API documentation. If you want to learn even more about SSRFs, check out this video about my report to Stripe. Already, two people have watched this video and found bypasses that I had missed, making $500 each. If you want to see if you can find another one, click the card on your screen right now. For now, that's all. Thank you for watching and goodbye.